फ्रेंड्स सब्सक्राइब कीजिए वाईफाई स्टडी चैनल को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए लेटेस्ट एग्जाम वीडियो सबसे पहले देखने के लिए। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू वाईफाई स्टडी चेंजिंग द वे ऑफ लर्निंग प्रेजेंट्स करंट अफेयर 2017 सितंबर फर्स्ट वीक एयर इंग्लिश। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एवरी इंपॉर्टेंट करंट अफेयर फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट वीक ऑफ द सितंबर। एंड फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम्स लाइक एसएससी बैंक, देन यू कैन परचेज आर वीडियो कोर्सेज विच इज अवेलेबल ऑनलाइन इन पेन ड्राइव एंड एसडी कार्ड। देयर आर मोर देन 300 वीडियोज विच इज प्रोवाइडिंग एंड मोर देन 450 मॉक टेस्ट, 100 डाउट क्लासेस। देर आर लॉट ऑफ कंटेंट दैट बाय विच यू विल इजीली एबल टू प्रिपेयर एंड क्लियर योर गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम। अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट, देर आर ऑनलाइन टेस्ट कोर्सेज ऑल्सो। यू कैन सी हियर दैट मोर देन 475 प्लस मॉक टेस्ट अवेलेबल, मोर देन 200 सेक्शनल टेस्ट अवेलेबल, 150 प्लस प्रीवियस ईयर पेपर इज ऑल्सो अवेलेबल बाय विच यू कैन बूस्ट योर स्किल्स सो दैट यू कैन इजीली एबल टू क्लियर आउट गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम। एंड इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट और क्वेरी, देन यू कैन कॉल और यू कैन डू व्हाट्सअप ऑन दिस नंबर 702-333-675। And friends, if you like this video, please subscribe so that we can provide you more videos, more content for the upcoming exam. So friends, first of all, we are going to start with the international section. After that, we are going to discuss the national, then trade and banking, economics, sports, everything we are going to cover in this video. So friends, let's see the first question from the international section. In which city China opens its first civilian drone base? Okay, so recently what did China? He opened his first civilian drone base. Okay, let's see the news first. After that, we are going to pick up the answer. So, the Civil Aviation Administration of China announced the opening of the country's first test flight base for civilian drones in Shanghai. Okay, so they opened in Shanghai. So, your answer of this question is B. And the base located in the district of Qingpu will provide service to thousands of unmanned aerial vehicles in a country where private drones have become very popular. So, as in China, in India, drones are very famous, right? But right now, there's no specified laws for the drones. Okay, so first of all, we are going to see some laws in India. What is the laws about the drone in India? So, friends, first of all, you need to remember that every drone sold in India must have a unique identification number. This is compulsory for every drone. Then every person flying a drone must have a permit. And if you are flying a drone below 200 feet from ground level, then you need a permit from your local administrator. Okay, so you need a permit from local administration if you are flying below 200 feet. And if you are flying above 200 feet, then you need one more permission from the DGCA. And you need to submit an application for this permit at least 90 days before you actual fly a drone. So these are the few conditions from Indian side for a drone. So let's see the another one. In which one of the following city Business and Climate Summit 2017 held? So the Union Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, that is Harshvardhan, addressed the Business and Climate Summit 2017 in New Delhi. So your answer of this question is New Delhi. Okay, and the summit has brought the world come together in 2015 and agreed upon the Paris Agreement under the UN Framework Convention on Climate Change. So friends, as you know that Paris Agreement is one of the best agreement or the biggest agreement in the field of climate change. So we can say the Paris Agreement or the Paris Climate Accord or the Paris Climate Agreement, it is an agreement within the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change dealing with a greenhouse gas emission. Okay, you need to understand this and you need to remember this, that Paris Agreement is for emission of the greenhouse gas. Okay, adaptation and finance starting in the year 2020, the financing and the adaptation will going to start. Okay, and there are 196 parties in the COP. 21 COP. 21 COP means Conference of the Parties, in which nearby 160 countries is activated. Okay, so your answer of this question is C. Which one of the following countries oppose the trade distorting agriculture subsidies given by the developed countries in WTO? Okay, so there are two or three nations which are opposing the trade distorting agriculture subsidies that they are giving by the developed nations. So they put their application in WTO. Okay, so India and China are the two nations which are opposing this trade distorting agri subsidies. So your answer of this question is E, India and China. And if we talk about the WTO, that is very important organization. It is an intergovernmental organization that regulate international trade. Okay, the headquarter of this organization, it is in Geneva, Switzerland. And the purpose of this is to regulate international trade. It was founded in 1995. There are 164 members of this organization. And who is the present leader? Roberto Azevedo is the head of this organization. Okay, WTO. So let's see another one. Who is Raul Castro? So this is a very famous person from the Cuba, friends. Cuba began its 5-month political transition after the death of Raul Castro, departure from the presidency, capping his family near total dominance of the country political system for nearly 60 years. So after the dominance over the 60 years, okay, Raul Castro departed from the presidency, and your answer to this question is E, because Raul Castro is the president of, okay, he was the previously president of the Cuba. Okay, let's see another one. Numaligiri Refinery Limited of India has entered into an agreement with Parani Energy Group of Companies of which one of the following countries? So as you know that Numaligarh Refinery Limited is in India, and there is one another company which came in agreement with this company is Parami and a group of companies. So you need to learn that which nation this is belong to. So symbolizing the great hydrocarbon engagement with India and Myanmar, the first consignment of 30 MT of high speed diesel was sent from India to Myanmar by the land route. Okay, so Numaligarh Refinery Limited, which has been supplying HSD to Bangladesh, dispatched the first diesel consignment through NH-37 across the Mora Custom Checkpoint on the Indian side and Tamu Custom Checkpoint in the Myanmar side. Okay, so they started their first journey on NH-37, and if you talk about NH-37, it is a national highway in India, and highway starts from the Sutukad. Okay, there is one place named Sutakandi near Karimganj in Assam. Okay, and this highway terminates in Bali in Manipur. There is one place named Bali in Manipur. Okay, so this highway NH-37 terminates there, Bali in Manipur. And your answer to this question is C, because it is the first consignment of their high speed diesel which was going to send to Myanmar. Let's see another one. In which city 9th summit of the BRICS countries organized? So as you know that terrorism in all its forms and manifestations strongly deployed in the 9th BRICS summit, there is a strong diplomacy win over in the BRICS by the India, and it was happened in Xiamen city of China. So your answer of this question is C. Okay, so the Brazil, Russia, India, South Africa is a joint declaration condemned all terrorist attack worldwide, including those in the member states. Okay, now let's see another one. Surya Kiran is a joint military exercise between the Army of India and. So this is a very important question, friends, because as I told you previously also, any military exercise connected between the India and the another nation is very important for you. Air Force and Army, Air Force and Naval exercise is not important as compared to the military exercise. So you need to remember the military exercise. Okay, first of all, that this Surya Kiran is between the India and Nepal. So your answer to this question is Nepal, first of all. And there are a few other exercises also that you need to remember, like Yuddha Abhyas, it is of India-US, then Aussie Index, India-Australia, Mitra Shakti, this is very important. Okay, this Mitra Shakti, India-Sri Lanka, then Malabar Naval Exercise, India-US and Japan. Then this one, Hand in Hand, it is between India and China. And Indra is between India and Russia, and Bangladesh, Sampriti, it is between India and Bangladesh. So these are the few exercises that you need to remember. Let's see another one. Which one of the following countries has launched Ujala Scheme? So friends, this is about the Ujala scheme. As you know that Unnat Jeevan by Affordable LIT and Appliances, Ujala was launched by the PM Modi in 2015, replacing the Bachat Lamp Yojana within 1 year of its launch, in which nearby 9 crore LED bulbs were distributed, okay, sold in the country, including their electricity, reducing their electricity bill by $55 billion. Okay, so this is the magic of the LED bulbs. They are 50 times more efficient than the condensate, and nearby 10 times more efficient than the CFL. These LED bulbs are very efficient, friends. So your answer to this question is Malaysia. Malaysia is now going to adopt this Ujala scheme. Let's see another one. Which country recently banned fundraising through cryptocurrencies? So recently, China has banned individual and organization from raising funds through the Indian coin offering or launches of a digital currency, saying the practice constitutes illegal fundraising. So your answer of this question is China. And if you talk about the bitcoins or other cryptocurrencies, then Bitcoin became the first decentralized cryptocurrency in 2009. Since then, numerous cryptocurrencies have been created. There are frequently, like, altcoins is also available there, which is also a cryptocurrency. I will tell you some more names by which, if a question comes from this, then you will easily able to remember. Okay, and like, there are a few others like Ethereum, Zcash, Ripple, Monero. So these are the few other cryptocurrencies. That's another one. So now, friends, we are going to learn about the national current affairs. So consider the following statement. Annual conference of Rajasthan Gyan Sangh of 2017 held in Mumbai. Objective of this conference is to enable a two-way communication between the policymakers and the senior officials. It is jointly organized by the Central Board of Direct Taxes and Central Board of Excise and Custom. Okay, so there are three statements that you need to remember. And first of all, annual conference of Rajasthan Gyan Sangh 2017 is held in New Delhi. Okay, so this is not correct. So your answer of this question is A. The second point and third point are correct, because as you see that this is a conference in which two-way communication happens between the policymaker and the senior officials, and it is jointly organized by the CBDT and CBEC. So let's see another one. The centrally sponsored scheme Rashtriya Vayushri Yojana is related to. So friends, Union Minister launches a scheme for senior citizens belonging to BPL category. So as you know that Union Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment is Thawarchand Gehlot has launched a scheme that provides for physical aids and assistance living devices for senior citizens belonging to the BPL category in Gujarat. So if a person is belonging to a BPL category and he is in a senior category, then he will get some government aids, like daily helping aids, like if you are not able to hear, then you will get a hearing machine and you will get a wheelchair. Okay, then you will, another thing, if you are not able to see properly, then you will get a specs. So these are the few government aids that are getting by the Vayushri Yojana. So your answer to this question is D. Senior citizens belonging to BPL category can utilize this scheme in the Rashtriya Vayushri Yojana. Let's see another question. Consider the following statement. Sports ministers approved constitution of a 13-member empowered steering committee, and the committee will sharpen influence Indian preparation for multidisciplinary events, including 2020 Tokyo Olympic Games. And this committee has the power to recommend specific plans or package for beneficiaries of target Olympic podium scheme. So friends, there are three statements. First of all, you need to remember this, that target Olympic podium scheme is made to increase the number of medal tally in the Olympics, in the next Olympics, which is going to be held in Tokyo. And friends, this Olympic podium scheme is made by Government of India, and the head of this committee is Abhinav Bindra, and there are a few other eminent sports person which are included in this Olympic podium scheme. Okay, and committee will definitely going to sharpen influence Indian preparation for multidisciplinary event, and the sports minister approved constitution of 13-member empowered steering committee. All these three statements are correct, and your answer of this question is none of these. Okay, because this statement are not correct. Let's see another one. The environment ministry launched an environment awareness initiative named Prakriti Khoj at the national level. It launched on which occasion? So there is another initiative launched by the environment ministry, that is Prakriti Khoj. Okay, it is basically environmental quiz competition in which environment quiz to be conducted at the national level, and the quiz is being launched on 5th September on the occasion of Teachers Day. Okay, this initiative will be going to launch on 5th September. And why this Teachers Day is celebrated on 5th of September? Because this is the birth anniversary of a great teacher, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, who was a staunch believer of education and was a well-known diplomat, scholar or a teacher. Okay, and these are the few things that you need to remember about. So it is celebrated on the birth anniversary of Radhakrishnan. Okay, this is the important thing that you need to remember. We are going to see the answer of this question, then C is your answer, Teachers Day. Which one of the following state has launched Arogya Bhagya Health Scheme? So we are talking about a state scheme, Arogya Bhagya. Okay, so Karnataka to merge health scheme launched Arogya Bhagya. In a move to ensure medical benefits to entire population of the Karnataka, the state government has decided to merge various health schemes and launch unified Arogya Bhagya to cover all 1.4 crore households. Okay, the Union Health Coverage Scheme would help the card holder get treatment in all the unpaneled private hospitals besides government hospitals to get treatment without paying any cash. And the main theme of this scheme is treatment first and payment next. Okay, so your answer to this question is Karnataka. Which city has been given India's first World Heritage City certificate? Another very important question, because Ahmedabad in Gujarat has formally quoted the status of India's first heritage city, with UNESCO director Irina Bokova handing over the certificate in the regard of CM Vijay Rupani. Okay, so there are a few things that you need to remember in this story. First of all, who is the CM of Gujarat? Vijay Rupani. Who is the director of UNESCO? That is Irina Bokova. Okay, and Ahmedabad is the first city which got this certificate. And India, as of now, India now has a total of 36 World Heritage inscriptions, 28 cultural, 7 natural, and 1 mixed. Sony project has been built on which one of the following river? So this is very important project because President lay foundation stone in the link of Sony scheme. Who is our president? Ramnath Kovind laid foundation stone for link 4 of the Saurashtra Narmada Avantar Irrigation Scheme, Sony Yojana, in Rajkot district. And this scheme was launched by PM Modi during a tenure in chief CM of the Gujarat. Aims to fulfill up to 115 major dams by diverting flow of water from the Sardar Sarovar Dam on Narmada River. So your answer of this question is Narmada. Okay, Gujarat Governor O.P. Kohli and CM Vijay Rupani and Deputy CM Nitin Patel were present on this occasion. How many amount has been spent on completion of phase 1 of the Lucknow Metro? So as you know, the Lucknow Metro becomes operational and the metro station was being flagged off by the Union Minister Rajnath Singh, CM Adityanath Yogi and Governor Ram Naik. Metro trains will be available from tomorrow morning to the general public also. Okay, and if you are talking about the money, then the cost of the first phase of this is 2600 crore. So your answer of this question is C. Let's see another one. Task force under the chairmanship of Niti Aayog Vice Chairman Dr. Rajiv Kumar was being constituted. So the task, there is one task force which is made on the job creation. Okay, this is made because of the unemployment. So as you know that to provide a major thrust to the job creation by enhancing India's sport, Niti Aayog has constituted an expert panel under the chairmanship of Niti Aayog Vice Chairman Dr. Rajiv Kumar. Okay, as you know that it is a new appointment and the task made is for job creation. So the answer of this question is B. And if you are talking about then Niti Aayog, then it was founded in 2015 and the succeeding, preceding commission is the Planning Commission, jurisdiction is the Government of India, headquarters it is in New Delhi. Okay, and who is the chairman of the Niti Aayog? PM is our chairman of the Niti Aayog. Who is the vice president? Or the vice chairman, Rajiv Kumar is the vice chairman and Abhitabh Kant is the CEO of this organization. Let's see another one. Who will head the committee that will identify key data protection issues? So B and Krishna committee to identify key data protection issues. So there is another expert committee has been constituted under the chairmanship of former Apex Court Judge Justice B.N. Shrikrishna to identify key data protection issues in India and recommend method to address them. So your answer to this question is C, B.N. Shrikrishna. Committee to identify key data protection issues, which is a major issue in the country right now. Now let's see some business news. What is the GDP growth rate of India economy in the first quarter? So if you are talking about the GDP growth rate of Indian economy in the first quarter, it is pretty slow as we compared with the previous one. It is among the top 5 developing economies of the world in 2017, even after the GST and demonetization. Okay, so you need to remember 5.7% GDP growth is the first quarter. So your answer to this question is D. Okay, so this is the thing that you need to remember. Saab and Adani joined hand for defense manufacturing. Saab is a company of which one of the following countries? So there is another collaboration between the Saab and the Adani group, which joined together for defense manufacturing. They are going to build defense manufacturing and entailing billions of dollars of investment, mainly eyeing a contract for single engine fighter jet for Indian Air Force. Okay, and the government is set to procure a fleet of single engine fighters for IAF and US defense from Lockheed Martin will be the major competitor for Saab for the deal. So your answer to this question is Sweden. Okay, Sweden joined hands for defense manufacturing. Which one of the following bank has been constituted by the BRICS nation? 5 banks of BRICS nation signed pact for credit lines. So there are 5 banks, friends. Okay, and there is one another bank named, previous bank name of this bank is New Development Bank, which is currently a BRICS country's bank, has approved $1.4 billion loan for sustainable development projects in India, Russia and China. So your answer to this question is New Development Bank. This is the previous name of the BRICS nation. Let's see another question. Disha Microfin Limited has been rechristened as. So there is one Microfin Limited company named Disha Microfin Limited who changed his name and again going to launch by the another name is Fincare Small Finance Bank. So the answer is D. Fincare Small Finance Bank is the current name of the Disha Microfin Limited, which is going to function within the 25 operational branches in the 4 districts of Andhra, Gujarat, Tamil and Telugu. Earlier it was all known as Disha Microfin Limited. And he was granted small finance bank license in the year 2017, who is the CEO, Rajiv Vaidya is the CEO, and headquarters it is in Bangalore. Now we are going to see the appointments question. Who among the following is appointed as a CAG of India? So as you know, the CAG is a very important body. Okay, it is an independent body which comes under the part 5th. And what is the article? Article is very important, friends, for all these organization 148. to 151 is the article which is provided to CAG. Okay, and it audits all the receipts and expenditure of the government of India and the state government, and also going to audit all those companies which have a government majority, say in the majority, like 51% has a government sharing and 49% private sharing, then they have a power to provide CAG to them. Okay. And the report of the CAG are taken into consideration by the Public Account Committee and the Committee on Public Account. Okay, these are two different names and you need to remember. And your answer to this question is Rajiv Maheshi. Okay, Rajiv Maheshi appointed as a new CAG, and who will replace the present incumbent Shashikant Sharma. Okay, there's another one. Who among the following is appointed as the Election Commissioner of India? Another very big position is filled by the Government of India, and Sunil Arora is appointed as the Election Commissioner of India. So the answer of this question is A. Okay, and he's a senior IAS officer of 1980 batch. There's another one. Who is the new railway minister? So who is our new railway minister? I think everybody know about this. And Nirmala Sitharaman gets defense, Piyush Goyal gets railways. So Piyush Goyal is right now railway minister of India. Okay, and Nitin Gadkari is in transport. It is Nirmala Sitharaman is in defense. And he is a minority minister. Okay, so these are the few ministers that you need to remember. Now let's see the next question. Who has been appointed as the new Secretary Department of Finance Services, Ministry of Finance? So friends, Rajiv Kumar assumed charge as DFS Secretary. First of all, your answer of this question is Rajiv Kumar assumed charge as DFS Secretary. Okay, and he comes under the Department of Financial Services, Ministry of Finance. Rajiv Kumar as Special Secretary and Establishment Officer, Ministry of Personal, Public and Grievance and Pension. Rajiv Kumar was Special Secretary and Establishment Officer, Ministry of Personal, Public Grievance and Pension, Department of Personal and Training in the immediate proceeding posting. So the answer to this question is Rajiv Kumar assumed charge as DFS Secretary. Who has been appointed as the Chief Executive of the Heavy Water Board on one of the industrial units under the Department of Atomic Energy? Okay, so as you know that nuclear scientist Kamachi Mudalai has been appointed as the Chief Executive of the Heavy Water Board, one of the industrial unit under the Department of Atomic Energy, Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research said. So your answer of this question is Kamalchi Mudalni. E is your answer. And heavy water boards has plants at Kota, Thal, Talcher, Hazira, Vadodara, Mangaluru, Tuticorin, and produce heavy water required for precious heavy water reactors opening in India. Let's see another one. Who has been appointed as the chairman of Central Board of Secretary of Education? So Amita Karwal R.K. Chaturvedi as CBSE chairman. So as you know that she is a very nice person, and she was selected from the 1988 batch Gujarat cadre. Anita Karwal replaces R.K. Chaturvedi as CBSE chairman. So the answer of this question is E. Now let's see some science and technology questions. In which factory India's first indigenous sniper rifle has been developed? So India get its first indigenous sniper rifle from West Bengal. Okay, the research and development for the sniper was done at the Ishapur itself since a year. Answer of this question is A. Ishapur. Okay, it is available in Ishapur near Kolkata. And the biggest advantage of the indigenous sniper is it will never run short of ammunition and spares. So this is the basic advantage of this sniper rifle. Which one of the following ransomware was hit Indian cyberspace? So as you know that because of the WannaCry, okay, and there are some other Indian cyberspace threat, Loki ransomware hits Indian cyberspace. So as you know that there is another one named WannaCry and there is another named Loki ransomware. Okay, if you have a file for or pics or anything in your laptop, then they will ask you about the money first, and after that you will give money, then they will allow you to access your laptop. Okay. So your answer of this question is Loki. A is your answer. Now let's see some awards question. Which one of the following country won Best Prize of Excellence Award at Delhi Book Fair? So friends, as you know, the Excellence Award given in New Delhi Book Fair, Dr. Mahesh Sharma, Minister of State for Culture and Tourism, give away awards for excellence in book protection in various categories at the Delhi Book Fair. The book which won the award here is a journal, Kurukshetra, has won Best First Prize while children book on Swachhta, Swachh Jangal Ki Kahani. Okay, Dadi Ki Zubani in Hindi and Assami, and Buddho Padesh in Kannada has won second prize. So your answer to this question is Kurukshetra. That's another one. Which one of the following entities awarded with the prestigious Rashtriya Khel प्रोत्साहन अवार्ड. सो फ्रेंड्स द लायंस फाउंडेशन वॉज रिवॉर्डेड विद द प्रेस्टिजियस राष्ट्रीय खेल प्रोत्साहन अवार्ड एज राष्ट्रपति भवन चेयरमैन ऑफ द फाउंडेशन नीता अंबानी कलेक्टेड द अवार्ड फ्रॉम प्रेसिडेंट रामनाथ कोविंद इन ग्लिटरिंग सेरेमनी इन न्यू डेली. सो द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज ए एंड दिस अवार्ड इज गिवन फॉर द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इन द फील्ड ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स. द अवार्ड वेंट टू लायंस फाउंडेशन. Which airport has bagged the National Award for Excellence in Energy Management at a conference hosted by the Confederation of Indian Industry? So, as you know that CII, okay, hosted an energy management conference in which there is one award given to an airport. So, let's see the name of that airport. Hyderabad Award Airport bags Energy Efficient Award. So, the answer of this question is B. Okay, Hyderabad International Airport Limited has bagged the National Award for Excellence in Energy Management at a conference hosted by the Confederation of Indian Society. What is the estimated cost of NHAI project awarded to Panjlod Varana in the Myanmar? So the National Highway Authority of India has awarded its first international project in Myanmar to a joint venture of Panjlod Varaha. It is for the upgradation of the Yaki Kalewa section in the Myanmar for the two lines. And the estimated cost of this project is 1177 crore. Okay. And will be completed within 36 hours. And this Panjlod Varaha bid was identified as the most competitive among four qualified bidders. Now let's see some sports question. Who among the following national hockey team has been sacked by Hockey India? So as you know that there is one famous coach of our in hockey team which was sacked in the previous week was Altman. Okay, so Hockey India sacked national coach okay Altman after a string of impressive outing at the international level. High performance director David John will be in charge till a new sustainable replacement is found for a smooth transition of the men's table. Now let's see some another question. Okay, first of all, we are going to see, we mark this answer of this question. So, answer of this question is D, not B actually. Okay, so there are another question we are going to see. Who among the following became the first wicketkeeper in the world cricket to affect 100 stumping in one day international? So, as you know that there is a single player of our one of the greatest wicketkeeper of all time, Mahendra Singh Dhoni, okay, got his 100 stumping in a ODI format. And he played 301 ODI for this. So, your answer of this question is MS Dhoni. Which company has been awarded IPL media rights for next 5 years? So, the IPL media rights to Star India, as you know that, Star India won the bid held in Mumbai for various media rights at the league of rupees 16,000 crore for the period of 2018 to 2022. So, your answer of this question is Star India has been awarded PIL media award, IPL media award, media rights for the next 5 years. In which category of the Commonwealth Youth Weightlifting Championship, Konsum Urmila Devi has bagged a gold medal? Okay, so Urmila Devi of our nation bagged a Commonwealth Youth Weightlifting Championship. Okay, on a very first day of the Commonwealth Youth Weightlifting Championship, Urmina Devi won a gold medal in the 44 category. Okay, she bagged the gold medal by lifting 75 kg in snatch and 76 kg in a clean and jerk for an overall effort of 133 kg. Okay. Macau is situated in which from the following countries? And there is another news that you need to remember is the Commonwealth Youth Wrestling Championship is been held at Australia Gold Coast. Macau is situated in which from the following continents? So as you know that Macau is in Asia. Okay, and your answer to this question is C. India beat Macau in Football Asia Cup qualifier. And this is the 11th consecutive victory for India in the international football matches. This is a very good sign for Indian football. Indian cricket team registered an all-win record cross formats in overseas tour against which one of the following teams? So as you know, India whitewashed the Sri Lanka in the previous game also and day before previous game also. Okay, in ODI test, T20, in all the formats, in India bowled it out the Sri Lanka. So your answer of this question is Sri Lanka. India won all the matches played in the Sri Lanka. Ankur Mittal is a player of which game? So friends, this is very important because I know that you didn't heard about the Ankur Mittal, but he won IWSF World Cup medal by clinching silver in the double trap event of the ITF being held in Moscow. Okay, he won his first IWSF World Cup medal by clinching silver in the double trap. So your answer of this question is shooting. He belongs to shooting. Dilip Trophy is related to which one of the following sports? So as you know that Dilip Trophy is related to the cricket and there are few different like blue, okay, India, red India. So there the teams are divided like this and it is played by cricket fans. Let's see some death questions. Sultan Ahmed, who has died recently, was related to which one of the following field? So Trinamool leader Sultan Ahmed is no more because of a cardiac arrest. So your answer of this question is politics. Okay, he is in politics because, as you see, that he is a former union minister, okay, of a sitting Trinamool Congress MP. So, what your answer of this question is? C. Gauri Lankesh, who was shot dead in Bangalore, is a. So, friends, Gauri Shankar, we are talking about the Gauri Shankar right now. Okay. So, Gauri Shankar is a fearless, outspoken journalist, was shot dead in Bangalore while she was returning to her home. She was known for her secularist criticism for right-wing and Hindu nationalist, including member of the BJP. And she worked for the Times of India and later ran on an independent newspaper named Gauri Lankesh Patrike. Okay, so your answer of this question is journalist. She is a journalist. Let's see some books question. Who among the following is the author of the book? Neighbors in Arm. So, friends, Neighbors in Arm is a book which is of Larry Pressler. Okay, so your answer of this question is B. As chairman of the US Senate Armed Control Subcommittee, Larry Pressler advocated the narrow famous passage Pressler Amendment enforced in 1991 when President George Bush could not certify that Pakistan was not developing a nuclear weapon. So your answer of this question is B, and he is a very experienced person who worked as a chairman of the US Senate Armed Control Subcommittee. Okay, so friends, these are the important current affairs from the first week of the video. Hope you enjoyed it, and I will definitely bring more videos like this. Please subscribe our channel so that I can provide you more videos which are very beneficial for upcoming exam. So friends, thank you and all the best for upcoming exam.